Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to South Haven First United Methodist Church, and it's rather gloomy outside this morning. But boy, the sun's shining inside this morning. Christina, thank you for that beautiful version of Mary Did You Know.
Everyone requested it.
It kind of has a special meaning for me. I love that song. I've seen Mark Lowry sing it twice in person, and it just stirs me every time I hear it. If you're watching online this morning on our Facebook page, we're glad that you're with us this morning also. We've got quite a number of church members here. We have several visitors with us this morning. We have a baptism today, and we have several members here from that family. Got to get my announcements in order. Excuse me. In order here, the Angel Tree Christmas giving was a great success. I'm going to let Cheryl tell you more about it if you want to. We'll do that now.
Good morning.
Yeah, Marcia and I did head that up, and it was a huge success. I want to say thank you so much for all that participated. It was a blessing to me. It was a blessing to a lot of people. They told me this was such a blessing to me. So I know it's going to be a blessing to the children. We adopted 14 angels, and they were all of them were fulfilled. So thank you so much, and Merry Christmas!
Bible study for the next 2 Wednesday nights. Going to cancel. Of course, this coming Wednesday night, just getting pretty close to Christmas. That's a week from yesterday. Boy, it's here already, folks. And that's for the next 2 weeks, and it will resume on January the 5th. We have Christmas cards available. Some of the church members, instead of mailing out Christmas cards, they put them in your box. And the box is, mailbox is down the hallway, about halfway down on your right if you're going down the hallway. So after service today, stop by and check and see if you have some. Today the choir is doing our Christmas cantata. Title of it is Bethlehem Morning. I think you'll enjoy that. I hope you were with us last week. The choir did O Holy Night. And all the years that I've been singing in the choir and with the choir, I've been associated with it, was probably, in my opinion, the best we've ever done. And I hope if you were here that you enjoyed it and that you received a blessing from it. And I think you'll get a blessing from today's cantata. After our cantata today, our church service, it will be a potluck fellowship meal in the fellowship hall. Even if you didn't bring anything, that's okay. Stay and join us and eat with us after the service today. We'll have a Christmas Eve candlelight service. That will be on the 24th at 6 o'clock. So come and join us for that event on Christmas Eve. We do have one birthday I see listed today, and that's Charlie Davis has a birthday today. I think Charlie's out of town right now, so I don't expect to see him here this morning. Any other announcements this morning?
At this time, as we come together, we will be lighting now the fourth candle, the candle of love. And I want to share with you in doing this, first off, from 1 John. 1 John chapter 4, verses 9 and 10. God showed us how much he loved us by sending his one and only Son into the world so that we might have eternal life through him. This is real love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as a sacrifice to take away our sins. Advent and Christmas come to us during the time of the year when the days are the shortest. In ancient times, the lighting of the Advent candle symbolized both the hope for the return of sunlight and the excitement of Jesus' coming, bringing God's light into the world. Three weeks ago, we lit the first candle. The candle of hope, which reminds us that Christ has come to be a symbol of hope from God into our lives. The second candle, the candle of peace, which reminds us that Jesus came to bring peace and goodwill into our world. Then last week, we lit the third candle. The candle of joy, which reminds us of the joy of salvation that Christ came to give to each and every one of us. And now on this day, we light the fourth candle. The candle of love. That reminds us that God sent the gift of His one and only begotten Son for one very special reason, because of His love for you and me. So help us now, O God, to live our lives thankful for the gift of love that You sent to us in the form of Your Son. Help us to now go forth from this Christmas season into the coming new year, living out this gift each day in how we love You, and how we love one another in return. O come, Emmanuel. Today we do have a very special time in the life of our church. I want to invite the Sarah family to come and join me up here at this time. For all their family, everybody, whoever, if they said come, you can come. If they said stay seated, you stay seated. Some of y'all are welcome to come over on this side if you want to. This is a true family affair. Boy, y'all, they got a lot of family, don't you? Amen. That's what this is about. Come on. Come join us. Brothers and sisters in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated to Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All this is God's gift offered to us without price. Ben and Morgan, on behalf now of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sins? Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church, which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races? Will you nurture this child, your son, in Christ's holy church, that by teaching and example, he may be guided to accept God's grace for himself, to profess his faith openly, and to lead a Christian life? Now you as a congregation, do you as Christ's body, the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ? And your answer is, we do. Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and life, and include this family now before you in your care? And you can read your response up on the screen. With God's help, we will proclaim the good news and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround these persons with a community of love and forgiveness, that they may grow in their service to others. We will pray for them, that they may be true disciples who walk in the way that leads to life. Here we go. Oh, yeah. Where do you want to go? Stay with me just a moment. All right. What name is given to this child?
Anakin, James, and Sarah.
Now, the water that we will be using at this time has three drops of water that came directly from the city of Jerusalem by the temple. Our good friend, Mr. David Lupo, has provided this for us. And so I'm honored now. Anakin, James, Sarah, don't be mad at me. I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right, y'all see this young man here? Give him a round of applause. That part is what you do. Y'all do know what you've done, right? You just promised God that you're going to be Jesus for this young man. That whenever he's here, he comes into this church, he's not going to see you. He's going to see Jesus living in your life so that he can follow not just in the steps of Jesus, but also in your steps. It's the same promise as Mom and Dad have now made. And so now, members of the household of God, I commend this family now to your love and care. Do all in your power to increase their faith, confirm their hope, and perfect them in love. And now, may the God of all grace, who has called us to eternal glory in Christ, establish you and strengthen you by the power of the Holy Spirit, that you may live in grace and peace. And all of God's people together said,
Amen.
And if you also want to share with you, this is the same baptismal font Morgan was baptized with. That's why she wanted to have him here today.
It says opening hymn, but it's actually our only hymn this morning, but it's number 246 in your hymn of Joy to the World. And we're going to be on the screen behind me, and we're going to sing verses 1, 2, and 4 as we stand.
just say the name, our minds are flooded with images. We may never have been there, but it's our backdrop for the story of Christmas, year after year. Yet long before that holy night, we imagine a scene that takes place in the courts of heaven. Here the Creator prepares to become the created. And here God commissions his angel Gabriel to descend to earth. Next, we find ourselves in Nazareth, where a devout young woman receives the news that she has been chosen by God to bear a child who will be the Son of the Most High. We see a poor carpenter awakened by an incredible dream. And then we watch as Mary and Joseph respond to God's call on their lives. Together, they set off on a journey of unwavering faith that takes them to the little town of Bethlehem and the amazing miracle waiting there. Bethlehem, that Naomi returned with her widowed daughter-in-law Ruth. In Bethlehem, Ruth met and married Boaz, and Samuel anointed a young shepherd boy named David king. The prophet Micah foretold that one would be born in Bethlehem who would rule over Israel. This night, in this little village, just 5 miles from Jerusalem, the prophecy is fulfilled. We watch in wonder as God sends our salvation. Oh, Savior has been born. His name is Jesus. We call him Emmanuel, God with us, Redeemer, God's only begotten Son, our Messiah, King and Lamb. Angels announce his birth to shepherds who rush to find him. And time after time, year after year, we follow those shepherds to bow at the manger and worship. the night is over, and the sun rises over Bethlehem. The silence of centuries of waiting has ended with a song of glory to God in the highest. The world will never be the same. God has come to us as a helpless baby. Morning has broken, and it's the dawn of redeeming grace. Just take note of the birth of Jesus and then go on with life as it was before. His coming demands a response. Who is the child who was born that night? Did angels really fill the sky? And did a new star show kings where to find him? What will we believe? Is he just a baby or the Son of God? Will he find rejection or welcome? Will we rebel or worship? Now is the time, and this is the place to decide.
Dark of night, the angel came.
Romans 5:8 tells us, "But God demonstrates his own love toward us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." And 1 John 4:10 says, "This is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Jesus came for us when he was born in Bethlehem, and it was for us he went to Calvary. We are the reason he came, and he is the reason we are here, and the reason we can't help but celebrate. Bethlehem calls us today. Worship, rejoice, give glory to God. Jesus is born."
Amen. Thank you so much for being here and being a part of our service and celebrating with us. Our Cantata. Yeah, y'all sit down. Y'all work hard. So anyway, thank you so much for being here with us. Thank you at home who are watching us on our church Facebook page. We so appreciate all of you being a part of this celebration with us. And now, receive this benediction. Brothers and sisters Christ, go forth in the love and peace of our Lord and Savior. Go forth to celebrate Bethlehem morning, to celebrate the true reason of Christmas, which is more than lights on the tree and gifts underneath. It is about the Christ child, born in a manger, not for himself, but he did it for you and for me. And all of God's people together said, Amen. Take care and God bless. And you at home, once again, thank you for being with us. You take care also and goodbye. Now, the rest of y'all just stay where you are for a moment.